Hello, my friends, and welcome back to my channel. Thank you for being here. Thank you for subscribing. Those of you that haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing. It really helps the channel. I'm wondering how many people are wondering, like I used to, when you have a panel board like this in your house that has a main breaker that's 200 amps, but yet when you go down the breaker panels here, you're 45, 40, 30, 30, you know, two pole breakers. When you add all these up, you're looking at 300 or 400 amps worth of power. How is that possible? Let's take a closer look at this panel board. So you see here, this is a main breaker 200. And then you have some 45, 35, what is that, 80? Right, there's 120, just in, no, another 80, right, 160. Another 60, 220. And then you add up all these individual breakers. Way over 200. How on earth is that even possible? We have a 60 amp EV charger here, and we get the EV, and this is the panel schedule. Boy, that looks a lot like my writing, because it is. How is that possible? Well, let me show you. Okay, guys, I got the panel cover off. If you do this, please be careful. This is energized. I have a Klein tool here that has an amp clamp. That's what we're going to be using today. How do we check the amps? Well, you just put the wire on the inside here between these two marks. There's a little minus here and a minus here. That's where you ultimately want the wire. And it will measure how many amps are on that particular wire being pulled. Okay, so let me see if I can get it around some of these wires. And the reason why I'm doing this is just because, let's say this breaker here, this 15, says 15 amps. It doesn't mean it's pulling 15 amps at the moment. What this is doing is this is going to allow a maximum of 15 amps to flow through this circuit. If there's anything more than 15 amps, this breaker is going to trip. If there's any more amps cumulatively than 200 amps on here, if any one of these is, if all these are pulling 15, these 30s are pulling 30, 40, if cumulatively it gets over 200 amps, then this main breaker will trip. So the whole purpose of these circuit breakers is not allowing all these amps at the same time to go through, only what's going on in the house at the moment. And let's see what's going on in some of these circuits, okay? So I'm going to take my amp clamp, and there's a setting on here. It shows amps with a wavy sign that's electrical, and there's a flat line which is DC. We want AC. So I want to put, let's say this first one's a 15 amp. I want to put it in here, and literally this one is pulling 0.01 amps. Given there's nobody home, but something has to be running here, right? You got a fridge, you got other things. Let's see, like, let me see what these are. You can look at the panel. Look at the panel schedule, air handler, condenser, double oven, stove, dryer, the well. So let's see if any of these, let's see if any of these other big ones are running anything. So you want to get this amp clamp on here, preferably all the way up. Same thing, 0.6. Just curious, but you can put it around here too if you have room. Okay, I can't see it like that, so I can turn it upside down. So right now, on this leg of the house, you got two hot legs, okay, on this number one phase. 1.72 amps. There was really nothing going on here. Just because nobody's home. Even if there was. Okay, 1.05 amps. So there is not much going on. The AC is not on. Nobody's home. I don't think the fridge is on. Even if it was, if one of these 15s were cooking pretty good, look at 0.09 amps. So the reason that you can have so much value when you add all these breakers up is each one is just protecting the size of the wire. That's why that breaker is that size. So if you're having trouble with a breaker tripping, some handyman may come and they'll say, hey, I'll put a bigger breaker. Well, that's not the answer, my friends. Putting a bigger breaker is now going to allow more ampacity current to flow through these wires than what it was designed for. So now instead of the breaker tripping and protecting the wiring, now the wire is going to melt before the breaker trips. So it's very important. Don't let a handyman or your husband or somebody else put just a bigger breaker. That's not the answer. The answer is to find the problem if there's tripping. So, but anyway, getting off subject, all these can add up to 400, 500, whatever it is. As long as you're not pulling more than this main breaker won't trip unless it's outside in the sun and it's really hot and it's heating it up, then possibly it will trip. But that is the reason why you can get away with so many breakers in one of these panels. You could have 30 or 40 breakers equaling a lot of amperage, but each one is sized to protect the individual circuit that it's on. So yeah, that used to throw me. I used to scratch my head going, wow, how is that possible? But all of this is not flowing. 40 amps is not flowing. 30 amps is not flowing. Just a small fraction at any given time is flowing. So if you're home doing dishes, you're cooking, so there'll be a little bit on the stove, 10 amps maybe, or something on the stove on the stove circuit while you're cooking. You know, maybe the range hood is on, so you'd be pulling a little bit there, but it's hard to find a house that at any given time is pulling more than 60 amps. It's very unusual unless you have a pool heater, an EV will pull quite a bit of amperage, you know, pull 40 amps or 42 amps or something similar. Unusual to pull much more than that unless you got a lot going on. You're running a business out of your house or out of your garage. You're charging EVs or something similar. So I hope that answers any kind of questions about how can this be possible. And some houses out there have a split service. They'll have two of these. They'll have one panel like this, 200 amp, and they'll have another panel right next to it, 200 amp, which seems crazy, but outside you'll have two main breakers. You'll have a 200 amp and a 200 amp, or 150 and a 150. Usually the reason why they do that is because the load calculations were too much for a 200 amp panel. The house is too big, needs too many circuits. Maybe they need more breaker spaces or whatever. But it's the same concept. You're not going to pull more enough to trip that main breaker, most likely. Okay? So, my friends, I appreciate you tuning in. If you found value in this video, please like, subscribe. It really helps this channel. It's going to help me a lot. I really appreciate it. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. If you think somebody could use to see this video and help them understand a little bit better, please share it. And I appreciate you being here. For everybody, thank you so much. See you on the next one.